turn to the person next to you and go, and Merry Christmas. Well, thank you all for joining us. We really, really appreciate you being here. If you're able to, could we all please rise as we worship the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords.
Our worship unto the Lord this evening. And thank you for joining us. May God bless you this year abundantly, like He has never done so before. You know this one. Come on, sing along.
Okay. Father, we give you praise and we thank you. We honor you this evening, Father, to prepare our hearts as we worship you this evening.
Oh, holy night, the stars are brightly shining. It is the night of our dear Savior's birth.
Thank you, Lord. What a privilege and what an honor it is that we can come and celebrate
your son Jesus, Father. And we thank you in this season of gift giving. And let us be mindful that you have given us the greatest gift of all by sending us your son Jesus down to earth to die for our sins. And as the song says, Father, we will fall on our knees and lift our voices as we sing with the angels up on high. So Father, be with each and every one here this evening. I ask that you bless them, open up their hearts so they may receive your message. Bless Pastor Matt as he delivers a powerful, powerful message, Lord. Again, may his words be etched in our hearts and not fall to the ground. And we promise, as we always do, that we'll give you all the praise, all the glory, and all the honor. In Jesus' mighty name we pray, and all God's people say, Amen, amen. Let's give the Lord a power offering. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, you take some time to go ahead and give somebody a big new hope for Christmas hug.
Christmas Eve. So if you don't have a bulletin, please raise your hand. Our ushers have some with them and help you follow along with the announcements. So bring information in here. You can either put them on the refrigerator or on your desk. Folks, we got this Sunday night. This coming Sunday. This Sunday morning, excuse me.
This next Sunday, we want to invite you to join us.
Perhaps you're looking for a home church, you want to extend an invitation to join us. We'll be at the Kauai Beach Resort this Sunday. It's our special New Year's service celebration, one service only, folks, 9:30 a.m. We'll have another wonderful pre-concert. The service starts promptly at 10 at the beautiful Kauai Beach Resort. We look forward to worshiping with you. Please, please join us. And then next week, Sunday, the first Sunday of the year, that's January 4th, back at our home church. We meet at Kapa'a High School Cafeteria. Regular service times are 8 and 9:30. The times and the dates are listed here, as well as information you need. If you're not sure where that is in the cafe on the Kapa'a High School campus. And once again, we want to invite you to join us for our regular service times there. That's the first Sunday, January 4th, Kapa'a High School Cafeteria. Folks, that's it for the announcements. Real quick, at this time, I'd like to ask the ushers to prepare for the collection of the tithes and offerings. And all this simply is an opportunity for all of us to be a blessing unto the Lord tonight. So ushers, prepare for the collection of the tithes and offerings as we prepare our hearts before the Lord. Would you pray with me? E puli kako. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, God, we thank you. We mahalo you, Lord, and we just want to come tonight and just pour out our aloha upon you, Father God. And we thank you for this time that we can gather and we can come and we can worship you, Lord God. And can I help but be reminded, Lord, of the three wise men, Lord, when they came and they saw the baby Jesus. They first fell on their knees, and then they worshipped, and then they presented him with gifts. And so we do so with the same heart tonight, Father God. We lay before you just the gifts of aloha to say thank you, Lord God. It's so money, and it's so small in comparison to all that you have done, all that you are doing, and all that you will continue to do in our lives. Father God, would you do what you do best tonight? Would you bless both the gift and the giver as we come tonight to say happy birthday, Jesus. We ask and we pray these things in Jesus' name, and everyone says.
The guy who was carrying the cake, that was my son. I thought, whatever you do, no drop the cake. And then if you drop the cake, just start flying them around, so they think that was part of the Well, thank you all for joining us. Hey, we so appreciate you taking time out to join us here on our first ever Christmas Eve service at the Convention Center at New Hope, Kauai. Now, you could have been any place tonight. You could have been home, reaching in the cooler. But you decided to reach into the things of God and be here at this service, amen? You could be home standing around the hibachi and cooking, but you chose to be around the fire of the Lord to be blessed tonight and honor his birthday, amen? So thank you so much. You know, in your bulletins, we got one scripture. Pray for me. I'm going to try to keep the sermon short. Because, you know, short guys can only give short sermon. Huh? because I know we all have family and things happening tonight, and we all want to honor that of getting together. But you know, you go ahead and take out a look at your bulletins, and right in the front, we just have one scripture that we're going to read. We're going to be talking about a lot of scriptures, but this one I want to read right off the bat, the Annunciation. The announcements, the you know, it is time. I always say that when, you know, MMA fighters are getting ready. But this is the angel of the Lord saying, I bring you good news that will bring great joy to all people. The Savior, yes, the Messiah, the Lord, has been born today in Bethlehem, the city of David. Now, we have a great announcement too tonight. We are announcing that those of you who have already given your life to Jesus Christ, we just can't wait when this life is over, we see you in heaven. Amen? And then another announcement we want to make. Maybe some of you have not made that decision. So we're going to have an opportunity tonight for us to make that before the Lord. And then we want to say to you, oh, when this life is over, see you in heaven. Amen? Now, you know, it's all about Christmas time and all about gifts and everything. You know, we heard the cliche. It's not about presents. It's about the presence of the Lord, right? But a lot of us are looking at our gifts and what do we get for one another. And how many of you never do all your Christmas shopping yet? Come on, be honest. See, get some people. I know every year, you know, the day after Christmas, get the meanest sales, you know. So if you get somebody for buy Christmas gift, you can go the day after Christmas and then deliver and go, oh, I never have time to give them to you before. Nobody, don't tell my wife that I'm doing that. Okay. Yeah. But all of the gifts that are going to be given, the iPads and the smartphones and the Kindles, Xboxes. You know what is one of the hottest things right now? It's kind of expensive. But people are buying drones. The aerial drones with cameras on top, and they're going to take surf pictures and all kind of other stuff. And even though the military is using it for other situations, but drones have happened to be one of the hottest things that people are buying. Kind of expensive, but can you imagine that? Drones. You know, but of all the gifts and all the things we stress about what we're going to give to one another, I know a couple, a husband and a wife, and the wife was hinting that she wanted a brand new car. But you know us men, we don't get the hint, huh? And all the women said amen. So this is telling him everything. Oh, my car junk, my car broken, my car old. Oh boy, and she really wanted a brand new car for Christmas, but he just wasn't getting it. But so finally, he asked her, what do you want for Christmas? Just tell me. Because sometimes men, you just gotta ask. Just tell me straight. So she tells him, oh, you know, I don't just get to the point. Okay, I give you one of the best hints I can give you. I want something that goes from 0 to 200 in less than 10 seconds. He looked at her and goes, okay, I'll get you on scale. Legos, video games, but all the gifts that are being given during this Christmas season. You know, we just had Black Friday, and think about it now. Not just this Christmas, all the Christmases before. All the gifts that were given over all of these hundreds of years. You know how many gifts that is? So how many of you ever had a gift you didn't like? Yeah, I think somebody gave me one canned Vienna sausage one time. And I was like, oh my, well, one of the best gifts I ever got was a gallon of OP. But of all the gifts now, since the beginning of gift giving, of all the gifts now, hundreds and thousands and millions across the world, right? All the gifts that were given out, only three stands out really. Three gifts of all across humankind. Three gifts by three wise men, right? Frankincense, gold, and myrrh. Trigis stands out to everyone in the Christian community. Amen? Trigis and these three wise men, I just gotta share this. People always tell me to share, so I'm gonna have to, okay? And here's my disclaimer for those of you who are visiting, okay? Here's my disclaimer. I am part Okinawan Hawaiian Japanese, okay? So Okinawans, much to my chagrin, have integrated with the Portuguese sailors in the island of Japan, and that's why we hairy a little bit and better looking, okay? Yeah. Okay? So I have the right to say these kind of things. Why wasn't Jesus born in Portugal? Because they couldn't fight three wise men. We have all the gifts. Some of you will get that later on, and that's because you're Portuguese. Of all the gifts that were given, of all the gifts, frankincense, gold, and myrrh stands out the most, right? You know why? Because it ignited a moment in biblical history. It ignited a moment in biblical history. All the gifts, all of the iPads and the Xboxes and all of the electronics and TVs and cars and all the money and gift cards. The three that is going to be forever mentioned is by these three wise men, or so-called kings, that gave gold, frankincense, gold, and myrrh. Why? Because it ignited a moment in biblical history. Those gifts given to the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords stands out forever. Amen? Tonight, we're all going to have an opportunity to ignite a moment in biblical history. In a few moments, as we go on in this service, you and I get to be a part of it. You're already part of biblical history, you know. Because this is New Hope Hawaii's first ever Christmas Eve service in the Convention Center. Come on, somebody. Just the fact that you're here tonight sets apart history. Now, do you know, and a lot of you do, that the word history is a compound word of two words, right? His story. Come on, somebody. And we all want to be a part of his story and ignite a moment of biblical history tonight with a gift. Now, let me ask you this. How many of you have people in your life and you go, they're just the kind of person where they're the hardest to find the gift? Or they're the person who has everything already. Anybody know people like that? Or they're so finicky. They're so, you have time to find them one gift. Anybody know people like that? Don't turn to the person next to you. What do you give to someone who has it all? Think about this. God has it all. Right? He has it all. He owns everything. What can we give? Well, we give something that really he doesn't own, and that's our life, and that's our hearts. And so when we give that to the Lord, we ignite a moment in biblical history in the annals of heaven where God says, this is the moment, this is the day that this person, you, myself, gave our lives unto the Lord. How much greater it would be if you and I, I know I didn't do it on Christmas Eve, but if you did it tonight on Christmas Eve, you gave your heart and your life to the Lord, and in the annals of heaven ignited a moment of biblical history, and it happened Christmas Eve, the first ever service for our church, New Hope Hawaii, God's church, New Hope Hawaii, in the convention center. How great would that be? Wouldn't that ignite a moment in biblical history and yours? How many of us, maybe we've already said the sinner's prayer, we went through the motions, and then maybe we sort of drifted away a little bit. You know, someone once said this, if God feels a million miles away, guess who moved? Right? And maybe some of us today, we go, you know, I want to reignite a moment in biblical history and rededicate myself unto the Lord and say, yeah, you know, this Christmas Eve, you know what's going to set it apart from the rest? Is that I'm not going to further my commitment. I'm going to say, okay, this is it. I'm sold out for the Lord. And if my heart was to stop tonight, I know for sure that I know for sure I'm going to end up in a place called paradise in the arms of my Heavenly Father. Come on, somebody. How's about that kind of gift? How's about getting a present like that? And then on the other end, the Lord is looking down and goes, I can't wait to get a present like that, a gift. You know, some of you have been looking at the media, watching TV, and reading the newspapers. How many of you saw this situation? The police all across the United States been stopping people but not giving them tickets and giving them something else. Anybody know what I'm talking about? If you don't, what we're going to do in a few months, we're going to take a look at this video right here that's coming up. And take a look at this. This is what the police department has been doing across America. Even in Kauai, they did it here in certain places. And this is what they decided to do. So take a look at this short clip of what the police officers and law enforcement are doing across America.
Most of the Kauai police officers have the general public design traffic stop. And you can find out a lot about that person in that 10 to 15 minute window, whether they're having a good day, a bad day, or a horrible day. And then we got this idea, what if we could change that person's day in real time? What if we could change that person's day right now?
Got all your Christmas shopping done?
No. Yeah, she wants like Lego Friends. I don't know if you've ever heard of those.
Oh yeah, yeah. My daughter loves Lego Friends. They're great.
Lego what? Friends? Daughter wants Lego Friends? Okay.
What about
you? Got three.
Any other kids or just the one?
I got another one. Yeah, I got a son.
What does he want?
He's only five. Yeah. But he has all these things that he wants that are unrealistic. Like, I'm not going to be able to get.
Like
this electric scooter.
Something like this?
Oh my God! Yeah!
Alrighty, well, open up the back seat of your trunk.
Was I really getting pulled over?
Yeah, you got pulled over. You got illegal tinted windows.
Oh my God, she just put it on the list!
And the,
we just went through a different list!
And the high school.
Oh my God!
Pretty awesome.
Oh my God, can I hug you?
Cool.
Am I getting it? I'm not getting a ticket, right?
I can give you one if you want.
You have to open it, right?
Have you tried those?
No.
Will those make you fit?
Exactly what I was hoping for when I
said that. What the heck?
You can't have that. And there's no there for you too, sir.
Okay, thank you.
So your little boy might like?
This should turn my bad day into a good one.
What?
Yeah.
Joking?
No, it just fell off the back of a truck. You know, you didn't see the guy with the ripped leg?
Sorry, the wrap job isn't perfect. It's a little windy out.
Huh?
Well, we have radios and sleighs and magic elves.
Xbox One.
Yeah.
That's what for your kid won.
Yeah.
That's the go-to present for your kid.
Yeah, but it's all good. They're not going to have it.
Go.
Yeah? Oh, my God.
How about you?
Huh? I'm looking at maybe a new TV.
We were talking about that for the room for a bit. Just scoop them over here and knock our LCD over.
Oh, yeah?
So you need a new TV?
Yes. Thank you.
Something like this?
Yeah, something very similar to that.
Alright, we'll open up the door, boss.
You serious?
Yeah. Merry Christmas! You're welcome. Merry Christmas.
Man, that's your advice, Sylvia. I mean, I've been pulled over by police officers before, and they've always been good to people, and never this.
How did that never happen to me? but think about this. These people were being pulled over, and you know, you and I, every time we see the police, okay, even if we never do something wrong with, like, no, anybody like that or just me? Right? Like, what, you know, when the police shows up at your house, it's never for good news, right? They never knock on your door and go, we just want to thank you for being upstanding citizens, and here you go, $100, right? But this is what these policemen did, and they blessed these people. Now, the people who were getting pulled over, they expected to be judged. They expected for the law to be written down on them. That's what they expected, but they got something else. Now, it's not that what they did is just swept under the rug. It's just that what they did was wrong, the infractions that they did. Some of them were not stopping at a stop sign, and others were, tinted windows, illegal tinted windows. Some of them were registration that were expired. But instead, they got a gift. Do you know that our Heavenly Father in heaven is like that too? Is that sometimes we think he's this big, bad cop in the sky. And all of us have infractions against us. All of us forgot to stop at a stop sign in a certain place in life. And things expired on us. Illegally had a motion. And when God comes, sometimes we just brace up for what kind of punishment that he's going to bestow upon us. And you know what God does? He focuses not on the infraction. He focuses on our need and then gives us a gift called salvation. It's not that we're not wrong, yes. You know, we did something wrong. But God didn't focus on what we did wrong. He focused on what we need to get right with him. Come on, somebody. What an awesome God we serve, amen? And once we realize that's the kind of Lord we have, we think about what we did wrong. Now, those people, I followed up on this story, and some people said the first thing they did was make sure they took off their illegal tints. The first thing some other people did was make sure their registration was not expired anymore. They made sure that they paid all of their parking tickets. Why? Because they realized, I just got blessed. How wrong of me would be to just continue breaking the law when the law could have just handed down quick punishment that I deserve. It's like you and I. It's like, yeah, we got caught in our infractions. But when we realize how much God loves us, that his focus wasn't what we did wrong, he was giving us what we need to get right. And then I gotta go, Lord, jeez, I was expecting to get slammed just now. But all you did was give me more blessings and love. I think I gotta go fix and make right what I was doing wrong. Come on, somebody. Not because he forced me, because he inspired me with his love. That's the kind of God we serve. How many of you received that today? So, we're going to pray, and we're going to ask everyone to bow their heads, close their eyes. And if you want to receive that kind of love from the Lord, if you want to come to a place in your heart and your life when you, yeah, I got it. God is not this big, bad cop in the sky ready to slam me for everything that I've done wrong. Yes, I know I've done wrong, but the focus of the Lord is not on what I'm doing. I did wrong. He wants to bless me with so many things that are right. And when I receive that, it inspires me because of his grace allows me and strengthens me to turn from the things that I need to turn from. But it all begins with this, receiving the ultimate gift of gifts. His name is Jesus Christ. The reason we celebrate tonight. When we say yes to him and no to the devil, all that heaven has for us is now within our reach.
So if that's you today and you want to say, yeah, I got it. I need that love, that grace. And I know it comes only through Jesus Christ. If that's you today, why don't you just lift up your hand and say, yeah, that's me. Lord, I give you praise for all of these hands. Just hold your hands up for a moment. Let heaven rejoice. You're igniting a moment in biblical history right now. It is a story. On Christmas Eve in 2014, Lord, I give you praise for all of these hands that are lifted. You can go ahead and put your hands down. Now, the rest of us, maybe we're starting to succumb to the legalistic religious spirit that tells us, you're wrong, you never make it, you gotta do more so that God's grace will be upon you with blessings. And then we try so hard and we keep falling short, we keep feeling guilty, condemned. Some of us been Christian 10, 20 years, we still haven't really understood the grace and the love, the immeasurable passion God has for us through His Son Jesus. Maybe today you want to say, yeah, I want to reignite a moment in biblical history and say, yeah, Lord, today on, I caught another glimpse of how much you love me. If that's you today, why don't you just lift your hand up and say, yeah, I want to reignite a moment in, Lord, I give you praise for all of these hands. Lord, I thank you for your grace. Go ahead and put your hands down. Would you all please repeat this prayer after me? As we light the fuse, as we throw a match on that combustible anointing and oil of the Holy Spirit, and we pray this in sincerity, please repeat after me. Say, Heavenly Father, thank you for your Son Jesus. Lord Jesus, I am a sinner. Forgive me of my sin. Thank you for dying on the cross and raising from the dead. I receive you now as my Lord and Savior. I choose to ignite a moment in biblical history because you deserve all the honor and glory. We ask this in Jesus' name. And everyone said, amen. Would you go ahead and give a God bless you? All those who have made a decision tonight for the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. No greater gift, no greater present. Not even Macy's can carry something like that. Come on, somebody. Amen. Now, how many of you are here today? I just felt it. How many of you are here today want to get married to somebody who's following the Lord? Don't be ashamed to go, you know. Yeah, I'm thinking about you see, that's the Lord that you give plenty hands. How many of you parents here today want to say, I just pray that my children will be so passionate for the Lord that they will just sell out for Jesus Christ. Come in. Yeah, all of her. All of them. Yeah. Wouldn't that be an awesome Christmas gift? That all of our children, and then those of you who want to get married to someone who loves the Lord, I pray that the Lord would send a tongue-speaking, devil-casting, prophesying, mind miracle believing people into their lives, and they'll never be the same in the name of Jesus. Amen? I want to close with this. On a cold December night in 1792, a young illegitimate boy was born by the name of Joseph Nair. He's born in Austria. His father had abandoned and deserted his unmarried mother. And he grew up, obviously, handicapped. And back then in that society, they would look down upon illegitimate children in some of the worst ways. He couldn't get into the best schools. They wouldn't allow him, receive him, accept him. He had a hard time with society and his peers, but the local church accepted him. And he said, this is the only place, Joseph Moore, as he grew up, said, I feel accepted. One of the priests there noticed he had some musical talent. Put him in the choir. That young boy got so passionate for the Lord. He wanted to get into ministry. But the church says no. Traditional church says you cannot because you are illegitimate. His minister, his priest, beckoned and asked all of the authority, please give him a chance, a second chance to what is important. Gave him an exemption, allowed him to go to seminary. Soon after, Joseph Moore will become a licensed minister ordained in that organization. He became a pastor of a very small church in Austria. In his second week there, it was Christmas Eve. He was panicking and stressed. He didn't know what to do. And he says, oh, how are we going to put on a presentable service for the King of Kings, a celebration for the Lord? He remembered, I got nothing. I don't have enough experience. But he did write a poem. He asked one of his good friends, who was a good musician, said, hey, let's do this on Christmas Eve. That poem, 200 years ago, written, ignited a moment in biblical history, turned into a famous song you and I know as Silent Night. When you all walked in tonight, you were given a candle. We couldn't light real candles in here because of the fire hole. But as the lights are going down, go ahead and light up your candle for our very first biblical moment igniting in the history of God, candlelight service in the Kauai Convention Center. Join us as we worship the King of Kings and the Lord. Father, we just come before you in the name of Jesus. Master, happy birthday. We give you praise and all the honor and glory for all of those who ignited a moment in biblical history tonight. His story, your story tonight. Lord, please see to it that everyone returns home safely. That when we go back with our families, we bring back the light and the love of Jesus and the grace of Almighty Father. Thank you, Lord, for these people. Thank you for you allowing us in worshiping you tonight. We love you. We honor you. Once again, happy birthday, Jesus. We ask this in Jesus' name. And everyone said,
yeah.
God bless you. We love you.